मूर्ति जी, इट इज अ हार्टी वेलकम टू बॉलीवुड स्टूडियो.
थैंक यू. नाइस ऑफ यू.
यू सेड इट इज योर सेकंड विजिट टू मधुबन. वी कॉल दिस फॉरेस्ट ऑफ हनी बिकॉज फ्रॉम हियर वी ट्राई टू स्प्रेड द फ्रेग्रेंस ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. एंड हाउ डू यू लुक एट दिस सब्जेक्ट ऑफ सेल्फ डेवलपमेंट थ्रू मेडिटेशन?
सो दिस इज अ वंडरफुल कॉन्सेप्ट. When I entered last time, 10 years back, I was impressed by the serene atmosphere and the vibration in the area. I was wonderstruck. How could it soothe my mind so much? Of course, I am an active politician, I am always busy, this one, that one. But 10 years back, when I entered into the Mount Abu gardens or the area, I felt that some soothingness. I did not get the answer on those days. Subsequently, when I went back and studied a little, then I was able to understand what it is. So this is my second visit. Even yesterday evening also, I had the pleasant experience of the same thing. So then I felt, why are you become so selfish? Why don't you spread it to every town and every village like this?
Murthyji, actually Brahma Kumaris is spreading this thing to every. Now we have centers around all around the world, 140 countries, I think it has been. And in every, it is a aim that there should not be any street without a Brahma Kumari center which spread this knowledge. That is how we are working. But we are working in a very silent mode without much
publicity.
Marketing publicity techniques. It spreads around by the word, and most important, as you said, by vibrations. Because there are people who are searching for that peaceful vibration. And when we keep on sending those vibrations, definitely they will catch. And that is the best marketing technique available on this godly service. Coming back to it, Murthyji, you said you went back and studied it a little bit. And you are from a political field with a hectic schedule, 24/7. So, don't you think that this serene atmosphere which we find here should be carried over to those fields, especially politics? Because we have lots of problems in the political field right now.
It is there, politics these days. Of course, I am in politics for the last 53 years. In my younger days, those days, politics was on principles. We were to fight on principles, fight for justice, fight for the rights of the people.
And we had such wonderful leaders also who propagated value-based.
And practiced. Look at our age group. We all fought for the freedom of this nation, freedom of the, when during emergencies in period 75 to 78, we all fought against it for nothing. We did not get anything back from it. I was actually imprisoned in the jail for 1.5 years, just for the reason I said freedom is my birthright. So those days, it was there. But off late, unfortunately, politician means he is not looked after with great respect now. Sometimes I get myself ashamed to call myself a politician. But the truth is, more than 50%, 60% of politicians are good, even today, Unfortunately, they don't get the exposure or the publicity. Whatever the good work they do, they don't get the publicity. That is the whole problem with political situation in the country. It is going on nicely. Look at our own Prime Minister. No one can point out a single finger against him. And we have got such a good Prime Minister. We had a man like Atal Bihari Vajpayee as our Prime Minister previously. Just I am trying to give you one or two pieces of examples.
Murthyji, there are great leaders even now, but as you said, the percentage is coming lesser and lesser. So, this is a dangerous situation. So, considering this atmosphere, whether political or economical in the country, what do you suggest? What solution do you suggest? How can we set things right?
Here I feel an ornation like this ornation, this serene atmosphere. If you just come out of a little, you are a little conservative. You become a little more aggressive. Try to contact more politicians. You can easily, suppose you come to Bengaluru, my home state, Bengaluru, Karnataka. You can easily contact hundreds of politicians, give them a little lesson, ask them to behave properly, give them some lessons or something like that. Try to contact them. Suppose you contact about 300, 400 people, 40, 50 will be impressed by that. That will help.
Muthuji, that is a wonderful suggestion from your part. We have Brahmakumaris is doing surveys by dividing the society into different wings, and we have as such 19 wings working under Rajayoga Education and Research Foundation. And one of the wing is the political wing. We are already contacting politicians, but as you said, it should become even more in a wider perspective.
A little more aggressive.
Little more.
I feel I do as a politician only. I came into contact with your movement. But your approach is very conservative, I feel. You are very hesitant, conservative. You feel your people, I felt, they feel they are, touch me not like that. Suppose they talk to me as I hold a high office. They are a little afraid of talking to me, are hesitant to talk to me, discuss with me, point out my mistakes also. You should create a small platform wherein you are free to observe. Now, look at the press, how do they behave? They try to point out whatever the mistakes, small mistakes, they show it and enlarge it and show it. I don't want you to do that, but point out that mistake, tell it to me in a proper way so that I can change myself, improve myself. That is the regular way of improving a man. Suppose you improve about 30, 40, 50 politicians in Karnataka, the whole situation changes there.
Definitely, Murthyji. And the mode of approach or the method of approach by the Brahmakumaris, you felt that it is a little bit conservative and reserved. Because I thought they might be hesitant in front of big office holding. Big people like you. If politicians can take some time and come into the Brahmakumari centers at least for half an hour, then a more open conversation can be had in the centers. And since it doesn't cost anything, just takes a little bit of our time from our routine, I think that will be one of the best ways to find out what is inside, whether it is mistakes or something, so that we can get a chance to clear it. Coming back to the atmosphere of the country, life starts from the family. Child is born into a family, and the family atmosphere holds a lot for the child. Looking into the family system of our present era, we have doubts in our mind. How can we make family relationships more intact?
No, that's a very, very pertinent and important point. Of late. Family means myself, my wife and my children, one or two, that's all. Even there, the parents, young parents, they have all become selfish, almost. They want their son or the daughter to become a big man or a big girl, big lady, earn money without any limits. What for the money, they also do not know. And earn. Or try to go to some other country, earn more money. What for? They are not bothered about the society. So, inculcate that feeling even in the small micro families also now. Now, micro family is a order of the day. You don't get the joint families wherein I was born in a joint family, in a big family. 40, 50 people were there. I was born and brought up there. My childhood atmosphere was totally different to that of today's children's atmosphere. So here,
what is the major change you noted in this difference? Was it that the value system was even more intact at those times? And what is happening today?
No, family, head of the family are those, they have become more selfish. They are not bothered about the child of the next door. But look at the way in which we were all brought up. I lost my mother at a very young age. I was about just 7.5 years old. I lost my mother. I never felt that I lost my mother. I was in a big family. Someone looked after me. And I came up nicely. Even though I lost my mother,
your family members,
I never felt that vacuum.
Your family members were there. They were so supportive that you didn't feel the change.
I didn't feel. So today, you just cannot imagine those things. So the way in which the people are behaving and family togetherness. So those things has to be encouraged in a modern way. You cannot go back to the old system of 30-40 people living together. But at the same time, we have done a small thing in our family. Today I don't live in a big family. Of course, so we have all small houses. But once in a way, say once in 2 years, 3 years, all of our family members we meet in a family meet. About 200-300 people of us meet together, have some cultural activity, have some Devata Puja, Homa, Havan. These things we do have. So that way we are like the family bandage.
You have a feeling of togetherness, oneness, a bonding.
And if anyone is economically in a bad position or something else, we support each other. This has happened for the simple reason, for the last 20 years, we have been meeting often. So that can be encouraged, that type of family meeting.
Definitely, family tie-ups are getting weaker and weaker these days. What you have said is an inspirational kind of thing, because I think family is the foundation of everything.
Family is the foundation.
And how do you think, sir, the practice of Raj Yoga and this knowledge which we are imparting free of cost, if we can take some time to imbibe this into our lives, maybe our family system will become even
definitely,
more.
Definitely. Raj Yoga or Dhyana or Yoga, anything. So even it should be tried to build up at a tender age also. Now that the central government is encouraging yoga system, I felt it today morning when I was meditating in the big hall. I felt this should happen even in a smaller houses also. That way, the young, tender age boys and girls, if they start doing this, now that the question of terrorism is also, the terrorism is attracting to the younger ones. I am really surprised. Young guys, boys and girls are being attracted towards the terrorism. If they could be attracted by that, why not they be attracted by this? This has to be, in a way, classrooms also, smaller groups.
We have good content in spirituality, but we need to be more. You need to make this content into such a system which is more appealing to the youth, so that youths, they come and catch this thing rather than going into different negative ways of whether it is terrorism or now, drugs or something.
Really right. Now you cannot prevent the youths from seeing or hearing those things through internet. But if you give them good things, don't say don't do this. Say do this. Positive. Don't preach anything negative. Today morning I observed, she was preaching us only positive things. That is nice. Suppose you start saying, don't do that, don't do this, don't be vulgar, don't do where. No negative things. Positive things will attract even to the youths. So that is nice. Today I was really thrilled in the morning.
Murthyji, it is a small thing which you said, but it is going to make an impact, great impact on the family atmosphere if this is practiced. Because rather than pointing out, picking and choosing negativities, if parents and elders, especially in the society, or those who are supposed to run the society, if they start pointing at the positive things, as you said, definitely in the near future, a great revolution can be brought into our society. So it's a heartfelt thanks from all of us. You took your time, even from a busy schedule, to come into Godlywood Studio and share all these wonderful things with our audience. And our audience also should be feeling very thankful to you. So, on behalf of all our viewers, it is again thanks for coming into
the
studio.
Very nice of you. I had a great opportunity. I felt honored. I am really indebted to your whole system here, and personally to you. I am really happy, really thankful to you. I look forward for some more opportunities from your side.
Definitely, sir. Thank you very much.